Good morning, everyone. So let's start with the class today. I was waiting for the participants to join in. And this class is provided by Sika guys. And you know that this is free of the cost class. You do not have to pay anything to attend the class here. And it's not like that. There are certain number of classes you can attend. You can attend, you know, classes throughout the week, Monday to Friday. And even we do have the class available on Sunday as well for the participants who wants to join on Sunday. They don't have maybe much time on the weekdays. So then you can have that 12 to 2 session. And also the recording of these classes are available on YouTube. You can access the YouTube Sika. You will be writing in the YouTube Sika Sydney. So when you will be going to that page, just subscribe it, because you will be start getting all the recording for the classes of PTE and IELTS as well are also available if somebody, you know, after IELTS and NATI CCL also. NATI CCL for the languages, Hindi, Punjabi, Urdu and Nepalese. So you see IELTS, PTE and NATI CCL, all of three test classes are given free here. No charges, not at all. You don't have to pay anything, no hidden cost or any number of classes you are able to attend, only nothing that will gonna happen here. We having this session since 2020 of May 2020, yeah. So we are running this like since last year. So entire year we just had this session for free, and even this is continuing this year as well. Besides that, we do have the migration counseling services, education counseling services, which are free. And recently there are, you know, certain changes happening in the processes. Anybody want to actually know about those changes, you can visit the Facebook page, Sika Melbourne. And there we have posted videos and updates. And just in case you're not sure about those updates and videos, you can call on the number and directly talk to the agent itself, right? The migration or the counseling agent. So this is how the services will be. And today's topic is going to be the next, like yesterday we finished up with the read aloud. So today we will be continuing first with the describe image, and then we'll be moving to the repeat sentence. That's how it will be. So first of all, the describe image, that what we'll be discussing today. And after that, for the another 1 hour, we'll be moving to the repeat sentence. And if we're able to, you know, finish some more of the item type of the speaking, definitely we will be doing that too. So here, the describe image first. So as the name suggests, it will be presented image on the screen. And we have to describe that image in our own words, right? That will be the task here. And in total, such like that, we'll be having 6 to 7 images, right? Including, which may have a line graph, pie chart, bar graph, Venn diagram, picture, map, pyramid, table, process diagram. So any sort of diagram can be there in those 6 to 7 item types of describe image. So sometime it can happen that every diagram is different, right? Type is different, or maybe it could be the case that maybe there is some are the line graphs, some are the bar graphs, and some are the pyramids, and that's it. There is no process, no map picture. So it could be a set of any combination, but we will be discussing every sort of the diagram here. And this task contributes solely to your PTE speaking score. That means it won't be like having any, enabling skill or the partial credit to some other module. It will be giving score to your speaking only, but definitely it will be adding good score to your speaking and improving the score a lot, because as it is solely contributing. So the main thing which we are taking care here is fluency and pronunciation. Definitely the content as well, but the content, how we are covering that, we can easily learn that. So what is remaining with us? The fluency. First thing to keep in mind always, that need to be really that we have to be really fluent. And the second thing is your pronunciation. So when you get an image on the screen, you will be given 25 seconds to prepare for that image. As we just discussed yesterday about all the timings and everything, preparation time, response time. So we have 25 seconds here to prepare, and after that 40 seconds to respond. And as discussed, when we have 40 seconds to respond, that means we must be giving our answer in 35 seconds, and that should be our target time, right? We should not target for the exact 40 seconds. and the reasons are that maybe it could be the case that our sentence is chopped off, word is chopped off, and I am not able to finish the sentence exactly at 40 second or 39 second. For to be on safer side, like 35 second is the target, we need to set that this is the time I have to speak for this image. 35 second means it must not be 34, 33, 30, because if you are after 8 band, then certainly you have to speak more. So 35 second is the safest zone possible. So if you are hesitating or not speaking fluently, you will definitely get a low score, even if you have described the image perfectly. So you see, the content thing, it's not that important. The more important thing is your fluency here. And obviously, the second is your pronunciation. The third come is your content. So it's not like that you're talking something random stuff and still getting marks. So obviously, you're talking the image only. Maybe you're not able to get the key content, but still you are at image. You're talking something from the image, anything from the image that will keep giving you mark on the content part. But just in case you felt hesitant, you fumbled, you have that umming, erring sound, you repeated yourself, you corrected yourself. If you're doing all these things, definitely your score will be lower comparative to if you're speaking fluently and the content thing, maybe it's not that very perfect, but still the fluency and pronunciation is up to the mark. So here, the first part of the image will be the bar graphs, very common. So this is how the bar graph can be. It could be really simple as you are looking at it, or maybe it could be a bit complicated as well. So this is an example of a bar chart. Like this is how it will be. It could be horizontal as well. The bar can be horizontal as well and vertical as well, right? So if we got a bar graph, beside the template is given. So templates are helpful. Why? Because you don't have to think which data I need to pick, because the template sentence will tell you what you need to pick from the image. So you see, when you already know, okay, I have to go after the highest value, so you straight away look for the highest. Rather than if you don't have any template blueprint with you, what you will be doing, you will be start learning the image, looking the image and taking out, okay, how I will be approaching to that particular sentence, or how I will be beginning, adding detail. So it will be like 25 seconds are not enough to, you know, prepare all those things. So templates come handy with that. So simply you have a template, you know that, okay, what I have to pick according to the sentence, you will be picking from that image. So you won't be fumbling, you won't be taking unnecessary pauses. So always learn templates because they are very helpful in the describe image. So you see the horizontal or vertical depending on the graph type, or maybe you can simply skip it. The bar graph depicts, this is also how you can start. The information regarding, so whatever is titled, that is your information regards. The data is calibrated in, so how it is, the data is given, 1,000 of tons, right? And what got the highest percentage? How highest 1,000 of tons production, it's in 1997, which is above 35,000 of tons, right? And the lowest, which I can see in 2001, 20,000 of tons, right? And almost similar with 1998 and 1999 and 2000, almost similar, 20,000 to 25,000 tons in between that, right? So you see, when you have a template, you already know, okay, this is what I have to pick up. Now, don't worry what is left. You have picked up the main key content of the image, content marks, 100%. You will be getting all the 5 marks. And what is left, how fluently you are speaking these sentences. It should not be like too fast, right? Your rate of speech should be normal, natural, with a moderate pace, right? And obviously your pronunciation matters. And then in conclusion, overall, it can be seen that this information is quite good, or maybe this graph is quite informative and knowledgeable. That's it. Just like keep this sentence handy, fix it with every conclusive sentence. Do not try to change or pick something conclusive from the image, because definitely you will be fumble. Or you will be thinking a lot, okay, what I can pick as a conclusion from this image. And definitely that's where you will be taking pause. And if you know in speaking, our pause is more than 3 seconds. Completely, we went silent for 3 seconds. Even at the beginning of the answer, at the in between the answer or maybe at the end of the answer. If we are having that continuous 3-second pause, the mic automatically turns off and our answer will be void in that case. Null and void, right? So better keep speaking. So rather than thinking of what could be the overall for every other image, better keep one sentence handy, just like in conclusion, this information or maybe this image is quite informative and knowledgeable for me. This image is quite informative and knowledgeable for me, right? Or maybe you can skip the word quite. This information is knowledgeable for me. This graph is knowledgeable for me. This picture is knowledgeable for me. So it should be like keep these few sentences, or I must say just one sentence, fix it up and say conclusion with every sort of the image you will be looking at. So this is the bar graph. The other type of the images will be line graphs. So the line graphs, they can be multiple line graph as well. They can be parallel line graph as well. And they can be single line graph as well. So three different possible categories of the line graph. This one is multiple, which is having three lines in it. And those lines are describing number of visitors per month in summer 2013 in three types of the museum, British, science, and natural history, right? And this is for a period of June to September, and the visitor numbers are given in thousands. You see, it is very easy. When you know, you have to go after title, you have to go the unit it is given in, and definitely what can you see on the bottom row. So you are going in that way. So this is the template for the line graph. So keep taking pictures just in case you want to have a record of these one, like how you can fix the line graphs. And with every image right now, I'm giving you a separate template. But at the end of this, all the images and slides, I will be giving you one common template for all the diagrams having statics in it and one common template for all the diagrams having non-statistical data, right, or information. So I'll let you know what is what I'm talking about here, but this is like separately. Now it's your choice whether you want to say separate template for every sort of the image you are doing in the exam, or maybe you're keeping those two templates, one statical, one non-statical, and learning them and utilizing them for the particular category of the image. Stat means when we have numbers in that, percentage, units, thousands, so any way the unit is given. And non-stat is when we don't have any data, like in numerical data. It's just an image describing a process, maybe a diagram, maybe a picture, random picture, maybe pyramid without any data. So that are called non-statistical images. So these few the phrases, they'll help you to frame the data when it is the line graph. So because line graph are like very easy to say when you divide them into three parts, the beginning, the middle, the final, right? Starting value, beginning value, middle value, and the final value. And you can also use vocabulary written here, the phrases, they are very handy when it is the line graph we are dealing with. The figures fluctuated between dash and dash. The figure rose sharply to reach a peak of. The number gradually declined to reach a low of. It gradually rose peaking at. The number eventually increased or decreased to particular whatever whatever change is happening up there. After several up and down, it touched the peak or low of. So you see, these phrases, they gel up very well with the line graphs, and you might need the out of one or two phrases when you are saying the data with the line graph. So just learn them, remember them, and utilize them when you need them. This is the same template which I have shown with the line graph image. Now pyramid. This is the third category of the describe image you may have in the question of this category. As you see, this is quite simple. What it is a formula for 100% well-being. And what it is containing, it contains a balance of exercise, nutrition, and sleep. that is equals to the 100% formula for the well-being. That's what the image is about. So you see, there are no percentage numbers, figures mentioned in it, just a random pyramid picture. And but we understand what it is trying to convey. Now, this is the challenge here, how you are covering 35 seconds here. So that's why I have that non-statistical template, which will help you to easily cover up 35 seconds. And obviously, if the image or pyramid is that simple, what you can do, you start adding the image shapes as well. You can start adding the image colors as well, right? So this is another way of extending your conversation in here in this particular question. Definitely we'll be practicing and we will be knowing how to do that. But right now, this is pyramid. And if you want to have a separate template for the tip pyramid, this is here. This one, right? Now the pyramid based task, you only have to read out text that you see in the pyramid. The heading title can mostly be found in the middle of the pyramid, right? Heading or title, it will be in the middle. So as you see this pyramid, the balance is not the, an ingredient of the well-being. Balance is like they are meant trying to saying, okay, what is the balance? The balance of nutrition, exercise, and sleep equals to that formula, right? So it's sort of a heading or a title. And normally it will be a multi-level image. Now, this is not a multi-level image. It is having equal share of these three triangles and that forms the complete balance, right? Normally, how will be the pyramids? Like you will be having different levels in the pyramid. And this, suppose it's a formula of diet pyramid, like what should be in a person's diet to stay healthy. So what should be the major proportion that will be in the last slab? What should be added in moderate quantity in the second slab, lesser than the moderate one here? And what should be least in your diet is in at the top of the pyramid. So you see, this is how the slabs or multi-level pyramid will be given. So if it's a multi-level image with the number of items under each level, as we go from bottom to top, number of item progressively decreases. So as the pyramid is a triangle, so obviously when we're going from bottom to top, definitely the value or the things given in that start decreasing. For describing, you have to start from the bottom level and work your way to the top. So this is the template, the pyramid outlines, lowest level, major factor, thereafter at the third level, the next level showcases, finally at the top of the pyramid. So this is the template you can use if you got a multi-level pyramid. And if there is no multi-levels, there is the pyramid as simple as we have looked in the image, then the last one I will be sharing that will be really helpful with that. All right. So these are the first three common images you will be having in your describe image question. Okay, the fourth one are the pie charts. The pie charts are the easiest one because normally we don't have to think much with the pie chart because every share of the pie, you see they have made different pie share here. So every share of the pie is quoting a figure or a percentage or a number. So that makes it easy to describe. We don't have to think much here. We know that this is major, this is second, third, then fourth and last, right? And we know that the color is telling about which percentage stands with which degree awarded, right? So this is the pie chart. And they are the easiest one to describe with each slice of the pie chart corresponding to a value. You can simply mention the highest and lowest figure and any other significant feature that can be seen very clearly in the pie chart. Even if you can including these three things into your description, adding obviously title, how the percentage given and what it is about, and then this and then conclusion, you can easily reach to 35 seconds. So this is the template you can use with the pie charts. What it illustrates, data is presented in form of crystal clear from the pie chart that the lion's share of, right? The pie is covered by which degree holder may be followed by which, then moreover, what other degrees are given. However, smaller part is occupied by, and in conclusion, it can be said that this pie chart is knowledgeable and informative for me, right? So this is how we can cover up the pie chart in the easiest way possible. Just a second. The next is the tables. So you know that the tables, they can be complicated as well, and they can be really simple as well. They can be with numbers, percentages in them as well, and they can be without any number percentages, just words in them as well. So this one you're looking at, it seems complicated at first, right? Because it got a lot of age groups, and then the activities and the hours mentioned, like whatever hour they are using on that certain activity, depend as different age group people. So if we are trying to cover each and everything here, sorry, definitely we won't be able to speak in 40 seconds even. We have to speak 2 minutes at least maybe, and then we are able to cover the whole thing. But you remember that our target is only 35 seconds. That's what we have to speak. So 35 seconds, according to that, we have to adjust the thing with every table. So suppose we got a table with numbers in it, just like you are looking at. So then we will be using statistical image description only, the one I'll be sharing. So you will be using that in that template. What is there? Obviously, first thing we are saying the title. The second thing, what the data is about, right? How it is given maybe. And then the first highest thing, then the second highest thing, then the lowest thing, right? And then overall, right? Or other, you don't have to say anything else when covering up the content of the tables of statistical one. So you see, with that template, it will be really easy. And sometimes the tables, they don't have any numbers in them. Suppose it's a table of a school schedule, and it is having days here, right? And after every day, they are mentioning, okay, it is having subjects here, days here, and they are telling which day will be, which subject we will be studying. Suppose this is how the schedules are, right? So there are no numbers, just the words written, like economics, history, right, mathematics, English, literature. So those are only mentioned here, and the days are telling us which day will be which lecture or which class, right? So this is called non-statistical table. And for that one, if we got such kind of table, we will be using non-statistical data template, right? Sharing at the end. So we have to decide for table, both will work depending on what sort of data we are looking at in the table. And this is common one, the next slide, the table template. So these are some starters, phrases that will help you to start or begin your sentence and give a length to a sentence. The table to pick, it is crystal clear from the table. On the other hand, it is also evident that overall it can be inferred from the table. So this is one very common template, but definitely we need more than that to describe the tables. So I recommend the last one I'll be sharing, use those for the tables. You can pick words here, definitely phrases, and it's not like that it will be going only with the table. It is also evident that it can gel up with any sentence you want to frame, right? And on the other hand also, right, it is crystal clear from the table, and you can see from the pyramid. So these phrases, learn them, because sometimes they add length to your description. And it is all about completing 35, 36 seconds fluently. Then comes the process diagram here. So you see the process diagram, that means something is processing in this diagram. There will be a beginning, then there will be few steps, and then those steps will be heading toward the end product. So that makes a complete process. So processes can be of two categories, man-made and natural. So man-made processes are when we human beings produce something maybe from the taking raw material from the nature and then converting into something commercial, right? That's a man-made process. And the natural one are like the naturally happening process, say life cycle of any creature, like how it was egg, then it becomes larva, adult, and then a butterfly, right? Like say life cycle of a butterfly. So that's a natural process. So we sow a seed in the soil, and how it become a big tree, it's a natural process. So those are will be natural processes, and something we are making, maybe taking something from the nature and converting to commercial product, that is a man-made process. So it will be of two categories. And normally when you'll be having it, it will be having arrows in that pointing in which direction the process is moving towards. And sometimes there are no arrows, it's just the lines only. And then you have to understand where it is beginning and ending. And first, in 25 seconds, this is your work, like to understand what is happening here. Like if you look at this one, what is happening here? From this radiata pine thinning, the paper making machine is making paper. And paper is the end product. And the process name is plantation to paper, right? And every step it is mentioned with an arrow, like what is next, what is next. And also it is told by the text, like what is happening at that particular step. So this is a process, complete process given. So in 25 seconds, you have to understand that what is happening, from where it is heading toward the end, and every step, what is happening at that place. And still, if you're not covering your time, then talk about the colors in the image, right? Talk about the arrows you can see in which direction they are pointing toward. So try to add these kind of detail if you are like already done and it is 30 seconds. But the conclusive sentence that need to be said at the end only. After conclusive sentence, don't try to add data. Don't feel like, okay, I'm just 30 seconds now. Okay, I added conclusive sentence. Oh, no. I have to add few more things on that. If then you are doing that, you are ruining the symmetry of your answer, because the answer always start with the intro, adding the key points, highlighting the key points, and then having a conclusive sentence. This is the sequence of the answer. And if you're ruining that, this will also go in a negative form. I mean, not negative marking is there. It will lower down your score, right? This is the template with the process diagram. So as I told you, there will be steps, stages, procedures, or such things will be happening here. So the word here, vocabulary here will gel up easily with the process diagram, like transformed, developed, converted, right? Next stage, after some time, further converted, developed, transformed into finally this pie chart, or sorry, finally this process diagram is quite informative and knowledgeable for me, right? So this is how you'll be saying the things here. This is the one other example of the process diagram template. The maps are the next thing. And as you are looking at, when you look at them first, they may feel very much difficult, typical, and not easy to explain sort of thing. But when we have a strategy ready and when we know, okay, how to go our way, then it will be really easy, whatever diagram you are looking at, if when you know and when you have a template with you, right? So for all the maps, probably you will be using non-statistical template, because maps, it will be already having names of the country, continents, nations, right? So this is sort of the information, or the sea's name, or the desert name, right? So these sort of the names will be there in the maps. So I won't be recommending the template in the next slide. Don't take a picture of that, because that is not helpful. But the last one I'll be sharing, that easily go with the maps. So after introductory sentences in that template, how you will be talking about the map, like left hand side, right hand side, middle of, what you can see, right? This is what you'll be explaining. Or the other way, top and bottom and middle, left and right. So this will cover the major content of the, highlight the major key content of the map, and then you have to conclude it up. Don't worry about anything making it much more complicated. Just keep it simple till the moment you're not fumbling at any cost, right? We'll be definitely talking about few images. So normally the maps, they do have a lot of country names in them. So be familiar with the country names, their pronunciation, because sometimes we know a country, but we don't know the right pronunciation, like how to pronounce the name of it, right? So like Ecuador, if you do not know it, Venezuela. So just go after and listen the pronunciation. And when you're doing maps, you have different country names, Peru and Prague, how you are saying those. So you should be knowing that, right? Just in case not sure, Google them, easily get the right pronunciation. Okay, so here are the Venn diagram. So you see, this is an overlapping circle kind of diagram. So two circles are there and they are overlapping each other. That means one circle is drawn at the other one. And what, and this image comes out at that, like this area, it is unique to the first point mentioned. This area, it is unique to this point mentioned. But this overlapped area, making an eye-like structure, it is sharing the characteristics of both the points or the subjects mentioned. So this is the common area, right? So if I'm writing anything in that common area, that means it is implementable to both the things mentioned in the circle. So in this case, this scenario, we're talking about the indoor and outdoor pets. So that means these are all only the indoor pets. These are only the outdoor pets. But when it comes to cat and rabbit, they're sharing both characteristics. They can be kept indoor as well. They can be kept outdoor as well. So now this is how the Venn diagrams will be. They will be having a common area, which having the shared characteristics of both the subjects mentioned and for the both different circles. And definitely what is out of that particular shared area is unique to the heading it is written below, right? So this is the Venn diagram and this is the template to the Venn diagram. So take a picture of it as well. So the Venn diagram depicts information about, and it is crystal clear from the Venn diagram that on the flip side, on the contrary, pick one. However, they also share certain characteristics such as overall, it can be seen that it is an interesting diagram regarding pet keeping, right? Or overall, it can be seen that it is an interesting diagram providing knowledgeable information, right? So this is Venn diagram one. Now this we called random picture. It is not having any title. This can also be in your exam. So the random picture, when I say you can have pictures as well or diagrams as well. So the picture means any picture. Now what you are seeing in this picture, a person, it's a sun setting time sort of, or maybe sun rising as well. Whatever we understand by that, we can say that. Now this guy is clicking picture. And someone is taking picture of him clicking the picture of Eiffel Tower, right? People are, there are very less people. So might be it's the morning time. There are 2, 3, 4 people I can see around it. What is the color of sky, right? What kind of structure I'm looking at? What is the floor color? What are the shapes on the floor? And which color I'm looking this guy in? What I can see he is holding, right? And what other monuments or buildings I can see far away, right? So all those things you are talking when we have a random picture. So random pictures, sometime you see, this is the, okay, we got this image. Now it is our understanding what we are looking at it. Whatever you can look in this image, you can talk about it. The colors, the shape, the size, and the people, the buildings, the tools they might be holding, right? And everything. And when you have that non-statistical template, the three sentences I usually give for the intro. So when you have three sentences, it will be covering around 8-10 seconds, right? After that, talk about this image for another 25 seconds and you will be done. And it's not big deal when we have already intro, when we have conclusion. It's just that what I can see in the image, I'm just talking about it, right? And frame good sentences. Sentence formation matter. It's not matter that you know it will affect your fluency or something, but if your sentences are not right, then it will affect the enabling skills, right? Your grammar skills, because everything is being recorded. So any wrong formation of the sentence will affect your grammar skills, what we call the enabling skills, right? So better watch your sentences. If you feel like you're making a complex sentence and it is not going good, don't make a complex. Say simple. Simply say, the color of the sky in this image has a lot of varieties in it. Firstly, the color I mostly seen is the orange or red hue of the color. But the other color which I can see is yellow as well. And somewhere I can see the creamish texture of the sky. And holy soldry, it is quite beautiful and pretty and delight to the eyes. And also the clouds, they are forming different structures like the sharp lines sort of, right? Just like a rocket just moved around these particular area. And down the cloud, what I can see, this long tall structure, I think this is called Eiffel Tower. And this structure is pointy and it got a strong base and it is made of maybe the hardcore iron. And it is quite beautiful in this scenario. And there are people also I can look around in this picture. So you see whatever you can see, and it is very easy to cover 35 seconds when you have few introductory sentence and when you know these tactics. So even talking about the sky, you can cover 35 seconds. But yeah, strategy matters. So this is the random picture sort of thing. And you can have any, just a picture of a pug, a dog breed. It is sitting on the couch. So this is an image you will be getting. Now you have to talk about it. Now just keep talking whatever you can see in that image. So that will cover your time here. And no template beside intro sentences and conclusion work here, because random picture, they are different. So we have to make our own sentences with the random picture. So yeah, these will be the types of the images you will be getting in your exam. Around 8-9 type of images are there. But out of those 8-9, what will be there in your exam? That depend on exam pattern. So the tips and the tricks for describe image. First of all, maintain fluency, right? Avoid umming, erring while speaking. Because if you're doing umming, erring, like if I'll be going like, okay, I'm sitting in a room, it got blue walls, it has a whiteboard in it, and I can see a projector screen as well, and there are a few lights and chairs and table and printer black in color. And the projector is in white color. It is quite beautiful. And there is a duster placed by the projector. There is a marker. So you see that when I'm having this ring sound, this will be reducing my oral fluency score. And definitely the overall mark for the speaking. So it's very important that I maintain my fluency and good pronunciation. You see the content thing we can easily cover. When we have template, content is no big deal. We got an image, so that's all the content, right? So don't involve too much in content thing that you lost the track of your fluency or pronunciation. So normally we have this pattern to speak or frame our answer in. So we got introduction of 10 seconds. We got highlight key points in 20 seconds. And we have to speak conclusion in another 6 seconds. So you see altogether, this is 36 minutes, right? So we are stopping before 36 minutes or stopping at 36 minutes. So that's why I say the target is 35 seconds. And why I'm not saying 30 seconds? Because if you are after 8 band, right? Or 79 plus score. So the thing is that the more you will be speaking, the more vocabulary score you're getting, more fluency score you're getting, more pronunciation score you're getting, and obviously raising the bar of your score. So that's why we say 35 seconds minimum. And the students who are after 6, 6.5 band, they can speak 30 seconds. They can speak, they are finishing their answer in 30 seconds, it's fine for them. But student are getting high, they should be speaking more, so that the more they will be speaking, the more score will be adding to their enabling skills. And yeah, try not to speak for the entire 40 seconds. Even if you try to do that, now the progress bar, you know that there is a blue bar keep on rising on the screen that called the progress bar. It's telling you how much time you left with. It's a rough idea. Obviously not stating exactly how much time left, but yeah, that will be giving you a rough idea. So you know that when it is about to reach end, it's somewhere around 35, 36 seconds. So that means you have to finish your answer by now. So sometime it can be the case that you are, you know, too involved in speaking the template-wise data. And then you look at that progress bar, it is about to touch the end of it, right? Now, what you should be doing in that moment, whatever you are speaking, just finish it off cleverly, that sentence, and say a conclusive sentence. Quickly say, overall, it is very informative. Overall, it is very informative, right? Understand this thing? Why we are doing that? We cannot miss the conclusion. We must not miss the conclusion, because if we're doing that, we're losing the mark. That means our answer is not complete. You understand? That's why a conclusive sentence is very important. If you're missing that, that means your answer won't be taken as a complete answer. It will be taken as the student is not able to describe the image in 40 seconds. Time was over, but he has not finished his her answer yet. And definitely not to be considered given good marks on this question. You understand? So even if you feel like this is already about to 40 seconds and I'm just speaking the content, rather than stopping there, just cleverly finish the sentence you're speaking as quickly as you can and add, overall, it is very informative. So overall word will indicate to the system, this is a conclusion, right? Finally, overall, but overall is easy to say. So overall, it is very informative, quickly. And yeah, this is why we should not miss the conclusion. And after intro, we are having the highlight points of the graph, pie chart, whatever diagram we are having. And then we are having a conclusion. These three things need to be there. And speak clearly, no fumbling, no. And just in case, you have to say 28%. And you just, by mistake, said 20%, right? Now you should not be correcting it. You should not be doing that. It was the selling of the car was 28% in 1999. Oh, it is 20%. So you are correcting yourself. You coming back, repeating the sentence. You taking a pause. You fumbled. So what happened? You have ruined fluency and pronunciation for you. Rather than you are speaking a wrong content, it's okay to speak wrong thing, right, on the content part, as compared to you are ruining the fluency. So even though you have said, and it will happen with many of the images you will be practicing, that you are saying the wrong data, the percentage you're saying is not accurately accurate with the diagram given, or maybe the name you are taking is not accurate. But yes, the more important is that you are keep speaking. You have not paused. You have not repeated yourself. You have not corrected yourself. You didn't fumble. You didn't hesitate. You didn't hesitate. And you have not having any umming erring sounds. So this is how you will be having very good score. This you can also do with the mock test as well, or anywhere there where you are assessed and given marks, any particular apps, website, links maybe, and you will see this strategy work, right? And now sharing the template, the one I said, the common, and then you only have to learn two templates. If you just going with those one, you don't have to learn separate template for every question altogether, then you just have to learn two templates. Okay, you see here, this is saying describe image statistical. That means when we have bar graph, when we have pie chart, when we have line graph, right? normally these have data in them, and sometimes the tables do have data, sometimes the pyramids can have data. So any image, when it is having data in it in form of number, percentage, kiloliters, milliliters, centimeters, any sort of unit, numerical data, then we will be using this template. It got 8 sentences. So the first sentence is introductory. The second will be telling how the data is calculated. And the third is a general sentence, various trend emerging. The fourth is where we are saying the maximum figure. The second is where we are saying the second highest figure. Sixth is where we're talking about the minimum figure. And seventh is that you, what else you can see. So quickly in one sentence, you don't have to say figures with them. Just say, I can see some more information regarding June, July, and August month as well. Right? Now, this word overall to be said. This must be said. It should not be like that. You're skipping it because you are starting with this. Overall, it is concluded that you should be speaking like. That's why it's bold, highlighted, and all capitals. Overall, it is concluded that bar graph is very informative and knowledgeable for me. Now, this sentence, keep in mind with for every conclusion. So obviously, bar graph gonna change with process, pyramid, random picture, or picture, diagram, right? So rest of the part, it'll remain same. So this is describe image template. And this one is non-statistical describe image template. So non-statistical, any random picture, any diagram, any Venn diagram, any life cycle, any process, any pyramid, any table, right, which don't have any numerical data in it, just the process, just the random photo, picture, just a table with no data, right, a Venn diagram, of course, with no data. So then we are using this very template. What it says, three sentences. This is an interesting image in front of me. This is going to be your beginning. Let me have a closer look at the given random picture. This is going to be your second sentence. And always say random picture. Some students tend to say, let me have a closer look at the given pyramid. So you have lost chance of speaking one more sentence. Don't do that. If the data is quite less, then try to actually extend it. So you will be saying, have a closer look at the given random picture. After having a look, I can see it gives information about a pyramid describing the food chart requirements. Right? This is how your around 10 seconds will be covered with these three sentences. And after that, if those are the maps and diagram, you are splitting them into three parts, right? So you will be starting like on the left-hand side, on the right-hand side, and in the middle of the map or the diagram. What you can see, you will be adding that information, and then overall, you are finishing it off. So when you'll be practicing, you will be knowing a few difficulties you are facing as well. So you have to actually practice and then come back with your queries. Okay, I got this problem with the image. I tried to speak it, but I was not able to cover. So you have to change. You don't have to change strategy, but add strategy. You have to talk about shapes in the image, color in the image, and anything visible in the image. You need to talk about it to cover your time. And if it's a process, then you go after stages, process or a life cycle. So I have given you enough phrases and the vocabulary with the process or the any sort of image with the steps in it, right? And then overall. And the random picture, they don't have anything specific sentences because a random picture will be, of course, random. And Venn diagram. So the Venn diagram starting with the same three sentences and then the template I shared already, you can use those sentences. Right? The common shared characteristic sort of thing. So that will become quite helpful. Right? So these are the templates and the type of the images. Right? You may have in your exam those images, and you can use all these templates I just shared with you. Now I'll be sharing few question of the describe image recent exam. So now you will be fixing the template with those question and see if those are working for you. If you are getting any issue, ask me now. Like this is, I'm not getting it. How to answer this one with the help of the template? Not able to fix that. Whatever you feel about it. Just a second, I'm sharing the screen with the image on it. Now you see this, we what we called it, what sort of describe image this is, which category it belongs to. Which category it belongs to?
Random picture.
Random picture, exactly. So if you got this, and this is actually a past exam question only. So if you got such image in your exam, so how you will be proceeding with it? And keep in mind, 35 seconds is the target. So try to speak those three sentences given with the non-statistical, right? And then what you are looking at in the image, start talking about it. Maybe talk colors, names, sizes, shapes, any other thing, anything exceptional. And then conclude it up. So just take your time, think about it, and at least try to answer this. One of you answer, try to answer this. Maybe that's gonna be the worst try ever, but yes, at least try. If you don't want to give answer to me, it's okay. You try at the place you are sitting right now, at your home, work maybe. Try to think about it, how you will be covering it. And you see, this is the another example. So you see, it's very complicated at first when you look at it. Aim for a healthy weight, BMI chart for adults. That is the topic. But you don't have to worry whether the data you find really hard to understand, easy or less, right? Just follow the template. So the template I shared for the statistical one, try to utilize it with the image you're looking at. So obviously it got 8 sentences. So just as per those 8 sentences, pick data, try to speak it and see if you're able to cover it and it makes things easy for you or not. And just in case you're preparing, I know obviously you will be trying to speak wherever you're sitting right now, but just in case you want to speak, write to me, just let me know. You want to give it a try, any one of you? Try to speak it with the 8 sentences. If anything you will be having a problem with, maybe I can provide you with the solution. And the images can be like this as well. I hope you have seen these two. Maybe you have taken a shot of these two images as well. The next type of image can be like this as well. Now you see what it is. It is about chemical transformation. And for such diagrams, you have to understand them. So you got 25 seconds. If you want to speak in the flow, understand them. But yeah, again, there is different thing. Like sometimes we don't understand the diagram. It may be possible. It's a sort of a process, but I'm unaware of what process they are trying to describe here. So in that case, it's just that go after the names mentioned, right? The arrows pointing toward, right? And colors in it. And then that's it. Try not to fumble. Just maintain the fluency. Like if I say for this image, you're not understanding, suppose anything. So you just start speaking This is an interesting image in front of me. Let me have a closer look at the given random picture. After having a look, I can see it is something about the chemical transformation with the nitric acid and the sulfuric acid. There are emissions to the atmosphere in the form of nitrogen oxide and sulfur oxide, and those are provided by the industry, transportation, ore smelting, and power generation. And then after the chemical transformation, they are drying and falling out. And then the gases, they went to the condensation state, and then happening the precipitation, acid rain, fog, snow and mist, that's the end result of that. And also some are going to the power generation, and which is detroiting the grass and making it not more worthy. Overall, this is very informative for me. Maybe the process I said it is not right. But the thing is, I just said from the content given in the image, I try to maintain my fluency and pronunciation. So even if you are doing that and you succeed in that, your marks will be full on full, right? So basically what is happening? So all those emissions to atmosphere in those forms, they happening with the chemical. There is a chemical transformation happening, already present nitric and sulfuric acid up there, right? So there are two types of things happening with the chemical transformation. One is condensation, which results in another set things, right? And another is dry fallout of the particular gases, which results in grass, or you can say the crops detritation, and also that also add up to the snow mist and the things like acid rain, fog, and precipitation. Basically, this is the process, right? So just, yes, Uma, you want to give it a try?
Now, I have a question, like, should we cover all each and every contents in this? If I miss out something, is that okay?
Yeah, it's clearly okay. Suppose I miss particulates and gases. Suppose I miss transportation, right? It's okay. Till the time you're not going back and correcting yourself, you're fluent and you're covering the content from the image and you missed something, it's clearly fine. You see with the process diagram, sometimes it happens that we start the process in wrong direction. So even we start the process in wrong direction, we must not go back and correct ourselves. Now I have started from the end and I'm going toward the beginning. Now it's okay. Now there is no way back. Now I have to speak the way I am speaking so that I can maintain my fluency. Content, and even if you're doing that, your marks will be still full on full. It provided that you were fluent, not fumbled, hesitant, and you maintained the pronunciation right. So still you'll be getting good marks. So that's what I said you. The key content in the describe image, sorry, the key content, I will say the master key to the describe image scoring is the fluency. Right. So one more image I like to show to you. That is again sort of a bit different. And other than that, if you got a normal, the pie chart, line graph, bar graph, those are easy. But when it comes to some random sort of the diagram, then it sometimes become difficult and we become confused. Okay, what should we are doing that? So my answer is never get confused. Just talk what you are looking at in the image and that's it. Now, this is the image of the map I want to share. So this is how the maps can be. So it is having a lot of country names, right? And nuclear power plants in operation in Europe, that's the data is about. And it is for the year March 2004, right? So now it's your understanding, like how you will be moving forward with this image. It got names as well, it got numbers as well. And if you go after the number, so numbers, what they are for? They are for the number of the power plants, nuclear power plants in operation, right? So even I can use the statistical one template and even I can use the non-statistical one, or I can mix both. So if I'm mixing both, I will be doing, this is an interesting image in front of me. Let me have a closer look at the given random picture. After having a look, I can see it is a map describing nuclear power plants in operation in Europe in March 2004, right? This is intro part, which I have taken from the non-statistical one. Now I know there are data given. So why not to move to the highest number? Okay, so from the map, I can see the highest power plants in operation are in the country France. That's what I can see, right? So 59. So they were in the France, which is a 59. The second highest are with the Russia, which are 30. And the least plant are with Romania, Slovenia, Sweden, Netherlands, etc. So there are many other trends I can see with Ukraine, Bulgaria, Hungary, Czech Republic, United Kingdom, and Belgium. Overall, this image is quite informative and knowledgeable for me. So you can mix match as well. So you see, when you are learning around these all templates, you will be having lot of sentences to frame your data with and lot of ways to frame the data with. It should not be like that you are sticking to, yes, if it's a suppose bar graph, yes, I'm sticking to statistical one only because that will be handy. But now it's a map with the number and the names in it. So it's my strategy how I will be opting the template. And I can only opt in this way possible if I have learned those templates, if I remember them. If I have not remembered them, I have not practiced with them, then ultimately you will see you will be fumbling a lot because you will be having that umming, erring sound a lot. Because you try without the template and you will see what is the result. Then try, learn the template and try with the template and see the result. You understand what is the importance of these and learning them, remembering them. All right, so this is the describe image. Just a second. So when in case the data is very much less, like these are the data when the VR images, when we have lot of data, we don't have to worry about like how I am covering 35. Instead, we have to worry about how we have to cut it short, right? Now, there are some images when actually we need to worry about how I am covering it. So this is sort of one image. This is a random picture, simple circuit with light. Not saying the random picture because it is telling us the process that it is showing a simple circuit with light. That is the process happening here. So now you see this is a simple image in front of you. So it is a challenge this time to complete 35 seconds, right? But again, non-statistical intro, random picture, closure look. Okay, then what I see, simple circuit with light, description of the process, right? And then start talking what you are looking at in the process. So there are arrow. So start with the negative one maybe, right? So firstly, the negative side of the this battery or cell, whatever you want to say it, the power starts moving up and then it goes straight and then it turns towards the light. And when it is touching the light, again, it is transformed and sent back to the positive end of the battery. So it actually completes the whole circuit, which helped the light to lit up. The light is white color with swirls in it, and bottom there is a small battery attached to it, and all the pointers, they are in red colors telling us the direction of movement of the electricity or the electric current. And the text written is bold and it is in blue color, and hold the figure, it got black color boundary lines in it. The cell mentioned it is circular, cylindrical, and having two colors, which is golden and black, right? So this is the another clever way of completing the data, covering the time. So you see, after talking about the main content of it, I'm not left with anything. If I suppose I'm just after the content thing, then I don't left with anything now. So how I'll be completing it? So this is another way. Whatever you are seeing at the end, remember that your sentences need to be correct in this case, because definitely, and how it will be happening if you are practicing. Otherwise, you definitely will fumble and be hesitant, having that thinking pauses, humming, erring, right? So to avoid that, give good practice to it. Understood? Any doubts here? Yes or no, maybe, or it's all good?
All good.
All good. Okay. So now we will be moving to the repeat sentence. That is the next thing we will be doing now. So bear with me.
Excuse me, Aman. If you don't mind, can I have one try? Actually, I'm having my own template. So if you can listen to me and tell me how is it going.
Sure. I would love to. Yes. Yeah. Can I set a timer for you?
Sorry?
Can I set a timer for you? Give me a moment.
Yeah, sure. Then only I will
let me know how long you are speaking.
Yeah, that's only I want to see as well. And can you play some different, show some different image?
I showed you earlier, is they are fine?
The planets one, that's fine.
The planet one. Yeah. All right.
So,
start.
This image describes about the planets, which are Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, Earth, Mars, Mercury, Venus, and Neptune. It also provides information about the topic in three different categories, such as category 1, category 2, and category 3. It is very clear from the image that the category 1 is the highest and category 3 is the second lowest. After analyzing this whole image, it can be concluded that this image provides crucial information about the planets, which are important facts and figures having great impact on it. Overall, this picture is very informative for me.
All right. Altogether, your timing will be 30 seconds.
Okay.
Yes. And definitely, I think everyone here aiming for good band score, which is 79 or more than that.
Yeah.
Yeah. So yeah. For that, you must be speaking 35 seconds.
Okay.
So maybe add templates are fine. You see, the templates work well. Okay. No template is bad till the time the sentence formation is good in them. It's just that you maybe need to add one or two more sentences to this one.
Okay.
Before conclusion or before, going towards the conclusion, talk about the color or the rings around the Saturn, right? And the size of the Mercury, that is the smallest one, the color of Uranus and Neptune, they are blue, but having different shades of it maybe. So try to add and try always with the timer that I must be speaking 35 seconds at least.
Okay.
Right, because that this item type actually drag our score to 19 speaking this particular describe image. So templates are fine till the moment the sentences are good in them, covering around the content. So it's fine.
Yeah. Got it. I will definitely include one or two lines after my. Yeah.
Definitely, you should be, because if you're speaking 30 for the images like this, so definitely speaking less, so less mark for vocabulary, less mark for your grammar, sentence formation, etc. So enabling skill bar will be not that much boost up if you are speaking 30 seconds. So if you're speaking 35 seconds, so definitely it will give it a boost. So that's what we needed. All right.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, no worries. All right. Okay, the repeat sentence, this is the one of the top scoring item type. This is going to be the second item type in the exam after read aloud. And this is the one of the most scoring item type of the exam. Out of all the question item types, this will give you the highest marks, right? And after this one, the next is read aloud, the one you do earlier in the exam. That comes into the second position, but this being the top, at the topmost position. So here you are hearing a sentence, right? And after that, you have to repeat that sentence exactly as you hear it. So when I say exactly as you hear it, that way you put focus on. Even if you remember three words from the sentence and you're speaking those three words, you will be getting marks for those three words. Right. And definitely there should not be pause when you are giving your answer. If you're having any pause, right, suppose I'm saying a sentence and that sentence I have said in 3 seconds. So if you are repeating the same sentence, definitely you are also repeating in 3 seconds or maybe max 3.5 seconds. Right. So suppose if you're taking a pause and completing it in more than that required time. So ultimately, that means you're not exact repeating it. And secondly, if that pause become more than 3 seconds, the answer won't be getting recorded and answer will be null and void, right? So this is very important here that when you start speaking the answer, you should not take pause. You should not be hesitant because that will affect your fluency score as well. And the master key to speaking is your guys' fluency. So here we will be having 10 to 12 questions. Why the marking potential is great here? Because the number of questions are like the most number, it got the major number of the question because no question other than this one got 10, 12 question in it, right? So you see, if we got 10 sentences, they are having around 10 to 13 words each and every word is giving us one mark. So let's multiply it and see the potential of this particular item type. So I hope you understand that why it is the most scoring. And this is a substantial score is contributed to your listening skills as well, being it an item type of the speaking, but two skills are working here. When we are listening, only then we are understanding what sentence it is. And then after that, we are speaking and giving our answer. Even sometime, like just in, let's take worst case scenario, I just heard a sentence and I just remember two words in that sentence, right? So better, there is no negative marking, right? So better that try to, whatever memory you have, okay, this is what was the meaning of the sentence. So try to give, add those two sentences you remembered from the recording you heard into a pattern where you are fixing the sentence with your own knowledge of the meaning you understand while listening. Right? So try to frame, because maybe possible that out of 10 words, you're able to get 5 just because you know the meaning and 2 words exactly you know. So other 3 words, they're matching up. Though like the articles, right? Like any helping verb in that, like any, the major key proper noun maybe, right? And sometimes the adverbs maybe or the verbs maybe. So this is like how you must be answering in the worst case scenario as well. But never keep quiet. If you're keeping quiet, it's not that you are losing the speaking score, but also losing the listening score. That means the computer understand this in this manner. Like this guy was not able to understand anything. So at least, you know, one word, two word, a word from a sentence, try to give it a proper, try to speak a sentence, because substantial score to listening definitely will impart, right? And rule, 3-second rule applies here. 3 seconds before the audio start, you will be having. And that we called, you know, getting ready time. So when it says beginning in 3, 2, 1, that means you must be ready to listen to the sentence. So you are opting different strategy to listen. That what we'll be discussing further. And when the sentence is over, microphone opens up 1 second after the audio ends. So as soon as the sentence ends, that means the audio, the microphone opens up. So that's your time to repeat that sentence. So you will be having altogether 15 seconds to complete your response. But keep in mind, any pause longer than 3 seconds will automatically turn the mic off. And then your 15-second rule or any rule won't apply, right? So that means when you have started speaking, you must be continuing the sentence just in case. Like suppose you know it, but you know, somehow you become hesitant, don't go completely silent, because microphone will open only turn off when you go completely silent. Even though you're making few sounds, that means you're still giving answer. It may be umming sound, erring sound, or some fumbling sound maybe, but yes, because but definitely that will reduce your fluency. So that is like when you don't want your mic to go off, then you can do that, right? But remember that definitely it will affect your fluency for sure. Now, when you are listening, your focus should be on understanding the meaning of the sentence. So if I'm saying this sentence, the building right in front of me is in a very detrited condition. So you got a meaning, you got a picture, right? That called visual memory and meaning got what is your understanding of what you heard, right? So when you are listening, so open the channel of the visual, you know, memory formation as well, and grasping the meaning of whatever you are hearing to, because that will gonna help you to remember more and more words in the sentence, because you will be able to relate the meaning to the words here, right? And definitely the visuals you have taken they will tell you, okay, she was talking about a building not in a good condition. So building, condition, not, three words you got same from the sentence. Even though you don't know the exact order, but you know those three words, you are saying them, you're getting marks, right? So focus on the meaning. So it will help you to remember the words. And it got, yeah, this is, I told you already. And definitely we should be taking help from the visuals we have. We are painting a picture when we are hearing something in back of our mind, right? So if I say right in front of me is town hall building with the flag with four logos in it. So what you are imagining? Town hall with a flag on top with four logos on that flag, right? So this is how we are creating the visual memories, and they are quite helpful when we are repeating that very sentence because we can take help from those memories. So many words we can relate, or maybe we will be much closer to the exact sentence, right? So other than that visual and meaning, you can take notes, the other thing, right? But obviously the note taking should be quite fast, quick, right? Because we don't have that much of time. So we must not try to write the whole sentence or whole abbreviated sentence because that is not possible. So how we will be taking notes if we want to? So we should be opting a strategy. Like if I suppose practicing and some student, they are easily remembering the first few words, but when it comes to the last words, they tend to forget, right? And some students, they don't remember the first word, but whatever they have heard recently, they remember well. So this is how our, you know, differently our brain works. So first analyze that, like which half you are better at remembering, right? So maybe it will be the first half, first three, four words, or it will be the later half, like last three, four words. So when you know that, like I'm good at remembering the last four words, but they remain with me for a longer period of time, but I forgot the first three words or first four words easily. So always opt to take notes for the first half of the sentence, and just the cases in the other the situation, then do the vice versa thing, right? So for take notes of the part of the sentence you tend to forget, and do not write every word in it, right? I mean, the full word in it. Write everything in abbreviated form in sign language, right? By using symbols, try to write that, right? And suppose if you have to write option. So normal abbreviation for option is OPT. Right? So you know that, okay, I'll be writing OPT. You have to write skyscraper. Now this is a lengthy word. If you try writing it, you might be missing the next, all the four or five words in the sentence, and even you won't be able to remember that. So rather than writing full skyscraper, just write SKPER, right? For you, but yeah, definitely should be understandable to you later that I have written skyscraper, right? So this is how you can take notes. And it said especially for longer sentence, but till the time you're not hearing the sentence, you cannot identify if it's a longer sentence or a shorter. So whether you are taking notes or not, it's a clearly your independent choice, right? You can take notes with every sentence if you feel like you are it's working for you. Or maybe you're hearing a sentence and you already heard around 10 words. And normally you remember the 10 sentence easily, but still there are more words in it. If you feel, okay, quickly write something for that, right? Because you won't be able to remember the 11, 12, 13, 14 word, right? So quickly, so that's how, especially longer sentence, if you're feeling like, okay, it's not over yet, quickly type, write something. So this is also you can do. So three things we can work on. And fluency definitely matter here as well. Repeat sentence and being at the top scoring, topmost scoring item type. We have made a supposed mistake. I forgot a word from the sentence. I mispronounced a word from the sentence. What is my target should be that I must keep moving. I must not stop. I must not correct myself, correct the pronunciation, or say the right word which was there in the sentence. So these all things you have to avoid if you want to maintain the fluency. if you're trying to come back and repeat yourself by correcting, of course, yourself or improving your pronunciation, maybe this won't give you positive score. It is not a human-to-human conversation, man-to-man conversation where, okay, the other person understand this guy is trying to correct the error she made, right? But here in the system, it will be like taken as a repetition, will be taken as content repetition, definitely pronunciation. Obviously, the word you will be speaking, you will be stop speaking and coming back to correct. So it will ruining pronunciation and fluency, so definitely you have ruined. So you should not be improving any mistake here. This is like a complete no to all the speaking item types, I would say. You will be judged on your pronunciation and fluency if you think too much, or if you haven't practiced your vocabulary or English speaking skills beforehand, it will reflect in your pronunciation and fluency. And of course, it will, if you have not practiced well, it will reflect in your answers. And there are some vocabulary words which have different pronunciation. So, you know, very academic words. And if you have practiced well, you will be coming across a lot of words. But if you have not, so you're hearing that word, you're not understanding that, you're saying something else, so you're losing that mark, right? So better to practice with a lot of different sentences so that you know, okay, this is the word I heard. In this pronunciation, it is said like that, right? This got the British accent, and this is how it is said in British accent. This got the American one. Okay, this is how, because you know that variety of accents you will be hearing here. And the podcast, if you got a phone, iPhone, podcast are the exact type of the, the conversation, the sentences, the pronunciation accents you will be hearing in the exam. So they are quite helpful. And other than that, you know, the different resources are available. Listen more and more audio in different accent, pronunciation, and different topics so that you come across vocabulary, accents, understanding those sounds, and you are not losing the marks here. Because definitely this will boost up the overall score as well. This is a repeat sentence, right? Focus on the meaning, first thing. Do not mimic the speaker. So when I say do not mimic the speaker, I'm not saying do not mimic the intonation, do not mimic the stress. What I mean here, do not mimic the accent and pronunciation. Because sometimes we're hearing the American accent, and if suppose I do not know how to speak in American accent, and I just try to copy the speaker and definitely making mistake of the pronunciation, I will be losing mark. Rather than I'm speaking in the way I speak, like what is my natural neutral pronunciation, I'm speaking in that manner, I will be getting full on full score, right? But yes, I must be copying the tone of the speaker. Tone means like whether the pitch was high or lower. It was in one go or it is having a pause, right? Tone. And rhythming, yeah, pauses, rhythming, I can follow that. I can copy that from speaker. And also the word stress. So sometimes, even I'm speaking, some words I give stress on, some I leisurely say. So that depends on the importance of the word in the sentence. So if that is, you know, done by the speaker, you should be following that. Because ultimately, that will be much then relatable to whatever you have heard and imparting you more score. And remember visually, right, as we just discussed, when even we are talking right now, you are imagining all the things in back of your mind. So those are imaginations, are your visual memory. Take help from them. Abbreviate the sentence if you want to. Like some student, they write the first alphabet of every word. Now this works for you. You can also opt that. This is very common non-strategy now. You know it, right? You want to opt it, try it. Try with different, at least 10 sentences, you have to go with one strategy and see if that's working for you or not, right? Sometimes some work for some, sometimes some work do not work for some. So you have to then decide on, now this is working for me. Like for me, I close my eyes. Nothing works me. Now, yeah, I do have visual memory. I get the meaning, right? This is what I work. But how I get, I don't write anything. I close my eyes while listening to a sentence. And that give me the most of from the sentence, right? So you can also try with that. Close your eyes. Try to get the meaning, words, mental picture. And then when it is time to obviously open your eyes as soon as the sentence finish, then repeat that. In the much similar way, right? So if that's work for you, opt that one. And brush up your vocabulary. As I just told you, it's important that coming across new words, not knowing them, definitely you won't be able to deduce what word was there, and obviously the sentence meaning or you won't be able to get because you don't know the meaning of some words in it. And get used to listening English audios in form of the different talk shows, different reality shows maybe, because there they have lot of things to learn when it comes to the language, right? And of course listen to news as well. So all these will be like giving you an English speaking atmosphere. So that will be immensely helpful when you're sitting for your exam, right? So these are the things for the repeat sentence. So now I will be making you hear the few repeat sentence, and I want you to try and repeat them and see if you understand them or not. Okay, here it is.
The sports team members often practice on weekdays and play games on weekends.
The sports team members often practice on weekdays and play games on weekends.
So what do you feel about this sentence? Will you be able to remember it as it is without taking notes? Or you want notes, or you want to close your eyes, or you want to get the meaning and then, you know, go ahead with the things? You get this sentence or not?
Yeah, half of it.
Okay, what it is?
The sports team members play on weekdays, maybe like that. It was
exactly. So the sports team members play on weekends. That's what you said, right? On weekdays.
Weekdays.
So you see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7 words you got, right, from the sentence. Mm-hmm. And how you will be getting marked for these 7 words if you're speaking them fluently. So the target should be, whatever I remember, I should be speaking it fluently in the right structure possible, right? Mm-hmm. So otherwise the sentence is, the sports team members often practice on weekdays and play games on weekend. If you understand and go after the meaning, it's very easy to then repeat it. The sports team member often practice on weekdays and play games on weekends. And now, you know, if you know the meaning, it will be really easy for you to explain it in your when you are doing it, right? Let's hear one more. And Uma, you also try to speak something.
Yeah.
Next.
The office opens on Wednesday and Thursday.
Yes.
The office opens on Wednesday and Thursday.
Yes, please.
The office opens on Wednesday and Thursdays.
Okay, so you see, you got the sentence when you took a little bit, you become a little bit hesitant, right? There you are losing mark. So it should be very flowy. The office opens on Wednesday and Thursday. The office opens on Wednesday and Thursday. Your flow should be matching with the speaker. So it needs practice. Definitely it needs practice. It's for everyone, even if I will be doing that. I'll be practicing for sure for this item time. Next.
You need to read the chapter before the management class.
We need to read the chapter before the management class.
Yes.
You need to read the chapter before the management class.
Exactly. You need to read the chapter before the management class. So it is easy. And they are all very recent questions. Next.
Talented people do special marketing.
Talented people do special marketing.
Talented people do special marketing.
Talented people do special marketing. That's right. Lovely. Next one.
I have a sandwich and milk for my breakfast.
I have a sandwich and milk for my breakfast.
And I carried it and didn't have time to eat it. I have a sandwich and milk for my breakfast. That's very true for me. Actually, I had these both and didn't have time to have them. All right. I have a sandwich and milk for my breakfast. Right? That's the sentence and that's right. Okay, next one.
The course will be tested at the end of the semester.
Mm-hmm.
The course will be tested at the end of the semester.
Neha?
The course will be tested at the end of the semester.
The course will be tested at the end of the semester. That's right. That's lovely. All right, next one.
Biographical information should be removed prior to the publication of the results.
Biographical information should be removed prior to the publication of the result?
Yes, biographical information should be removed prior to the publication of the results. But yet that should be in one go. Biographical information should be removed prior to the publication of the results. Yes, Uma?
I have a question. If I didn't hear the first word, how shall I proceed with the biographical information? I didn't hear it. I couldn't understand it. So how can I proceed it?
So whatever you understand, you should be saying that. What do you understand? What you got from this one?
Yeah, I forgot.
Okay. So just in case, suppose it's biographical information and you didn't get this word, right? Yeah. And rest all of the words you remember or rest all of the sequence you remember, start from there. Should be removed prior to the publication of the results.
Okay.
So for every word you are speaking from the sentence, you will be given score. And if you are fluent, your fluency score will be given. Pronunciation is correct, your pronunciation score will be given. Content part score will be less, like two words you have missed. So 2 marks will be less in that, right? Okay. But yeah, remaining all the things you have to mend. Even though you remember only 2 words, 3 words, right? Speak with good pronunciation and fluency. Your content score is at risk of not speaking the word, but the other two skills, you can still achieve the full score, like the way you are, you know, speaking the sentence. And even sometime you can frame the sentence from the little knowledge you got. So maybe you get this biographical information as such as some other word, but you know that maybe this is what I heard. You said that whatever word is right, content part score will be there, but fluency pronunciation, that will be 515 if you are, you know, maintaining both. Okay, next one.
The United States is the largest chocolate manufacturing country.
The United States has the largest chocolate manufacturing in the country.
All right.
But the United States. The United States is the second largest chocolate manufacturing company.
No, the
country. Sorry.
Yeah, listen again.
The United States is the largest chocolate manufacturing country.
The United States is the largest chocolate manufacturing country.
The United States is the largest chocolate manufacturing country. You see how simple the sentence is, but yet tricky. United States is the largest chocolate manufacturer because it got lot of, you see, adjective, largest. Then there is a chocolate, then manufacturing, then comes the country. So that makes it a bit tricky and difficult, even though it seems easy. Next one.
Children are not allowed to be in the laboratory at any time.
Yeah, I missed it.
Okay.
In the laboratory at any time. I just got this thing.
Are not allowed in the laboratory at any time.
Okay, the sentence itself is, here it is.
Children are not allowed to be in the laboratory at any time.
Oh. Children are not allowed to be in the laboratory at any time.
Yes, children are not allowed to be in the laboratory at any time. Okay, next one. And these are there in the exam recently, guys, the sentences we are doing right now. So this one, it was there in the 18 January exam, and also in the last week in 27 January exam. Okay, this one, what it is. Yeah.
If you forget your passport, you need to contact the student center.
If you forgot your passport, you need to contact the student center.
So why you corrected yourself? Contact. It's okay. Yeah. Now go ahead. If you forgot your passport, you need to contact the student center.
Yeah.
Next.
The quality of our accommodation is high, but it is still affordable for students.
The quality of accommodation is high, but it is still affordable for the students.
Mm-hmm. You got it, Neha?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll play it again. You say it.
The quality of our accommodation is high, but it is still affordable for students.
The quality of our accommodation is high, but you still need to pay for the...
The quality of our accommodation is high, but it is still affordable for students. The quality is high, but still affordable. Next one, and then I'll be sharing that marking criteria scheme.
An extra lecture is about to be scheduled at the end of this week to assist you with revision. An extra lecture is about to be scheduled at the end of this week to assist you with revision.
The extra lecture will be scheduled at the end of this week to assist you with revision.
Yeah, roundabout same, not exactly. An extra lecture is about to be scheduled at the end of this week to assist you with revision. An extra lecture is about to be scheduled at the end of this week to assist you with revision.
An extra lecture is about to be scheduled at the end of this week to assist you with revision.
Now the problem is, now the word schedule, it got two pronunciation. Right?
Yeah.
So that make us fumble. So for such things, the pronunciation things, if we just having this, like the speaker said it like this way, but this is not usually I speak it. Maybe I use the other way of the pronunciation. Go with that.
Okay.
Not to copy the pronunciation in that case, because as I told you, different accents, so different pronunciation. So I'm keeping my accent neutral. So both will be acceptable. Right.
So I have a question. So these clips are available on the YouTube or internet for the practicing?
Yes, YouTube, internet, everywhere you got the clips.
The recent questions.
The recent exam question. Now this is the data I am having, right? Mm-hmm. And yes, this is available on the internet as well, but it's like, I don't know, it's in the same pattern I am doing it. Or maybe you go after, I guess, YouTube videos and then you simply search repeat sentence and you will be getting links in the Google and go after them. And even though they are not just now sort of repetitive question, but there is a trend in PT, like you're doing practice, definitely, first of all, you get fruits of that, right? And you never know, even the last year exam question can be there in today's exam as well. So it's like no practice is wasted here. So do practice whatever question you are getting, right? Okay, so this was the repeat sentence. And you see, Kimberly, remember Uma? You remember Kimberly?
Yeah,
she got 90 overall, right?
And 90, very good. Yeah,
listening, she got 90. Mm-hmm. Speaking, she got 90. Writing, she got 87 and reading she got 84. That was her score. Yeah. But you see, the one thing I seen in that girl is she is so consistent. I mean, when we started the classes, after 1 or 2 months, she joined in. And she was there till the time on 26th of this January, she gave exam. So she was like doing a lot of practice. And that way I can see practice don't go wasted. It pays off. And in the first very attempt, she got the score. Right. And this repeat sentence, when she started doing that, the way, you know, we fumble normally, we miss the words or we don't get the things right. But when it was near to her exam, even I was like, sometime I got surprised to see even the lengthy sort of words she was able to speak as it is. You know, lengthy sentence, maybe 15 words in it, 16, she's able to repeat that. And that only come with practice. So it's like PTE. Yes, it is. Like whatever score we after, we able to achieve that, but we have to devote it to practice. That's the only thing which I have learned in that entire year and from her performance as well. All right, so I'll just quickly share this image and then we'll be end this session. So I'll tell you why repeat sentence and how much it is contributing. So here is the image, I believe. Oh, where? Yeah, here it is. You can keep this image as a screenshot or a picture with you as well. So this will keep telling you which questions you need to practice if you're having certain less score in some other image or sort of thing. Like you see repeat sentence at the topmost position, right? And right from dictation of the listening, they are in the second. Reading and filling in the blanks, third. Read aloud in the fourth. So when you look at these four item types, they are contributing around 120 marks to the overall. To the overall of 360. So you see a lot of marks. And out of those 120 or 110 marks, 51 or 52 marks only coming from repeat sentence. So these are the ways you can boost your performance. When you know where to actually put focus on, where to put practice on, and if I am lacking in certain particular skill or enabling skill, so where I am going and practice and improving that particular bar or skill, so this is a helpful tool for that, right? 51.8, right? 10 to 12 question, 32 will remain with the speaking, but 19.7 score will be imparted to your listening. So on an average, 22 listening, 32 to speaking. That's the division of the score. So that's why if you're not able to hear the sentence exactly, but speaking it may be wrong, losing mark on the content, for sure it's okay. But yeah, I am maintaining fluency and pronunciation, which will again, speaking score will boost up. But if I'm speaking, right, my listening score will definitely impart it. So I will be still receiving that 20 marks if I'm maybe framing a sentences with the knowledge I just got from the meaning of the sentence, and I'm just framing it, keeping the words in it, whatever I remember from the sentence, and then framing it in the closest way possible to the recording I heard. I hope you get my point, right? So you're not getting words, it's okay, but speaking will definitely help you. So if sometime you didn't get anything, say something. Don't go silent, because that will ultimately give you the listening score for sure. That's how the computer works, right? So this is why this is important to know, and these strategies, little things, tips definitely boost up the score. Okay, guys, that's all for today. So tomorrow we'll be continuing with the next item type, and that will be retail lecture and answer short question. And we will be starting with the writing as well tomorrow, because 1 hour we'll be covering easily the speaking left ones, and then we'll be moving to writing and covering the essay part, right? Okay, so can we end this session now? It's 12, right?
Yeah, thank you.
All right, Uma and Nihal. Yeah.
Thank you so much, Aman.
Guys, have a lovely day ahead. Yeah, bye-bye. Take care. Bye. So my name is Session 9. Bye.
Bye.
Bye-bye.